With me now is Charles Woods. He's the father of a U.S. Navy SEAL, Tyrone Woods, who was also killed in the attack on the consulate in Benghazi. Thank you, sir, for being here.
Good morning. Thank you.
Good morning. When you hear Hillary Clinton saying what she just said, what goes through your mind?
Well, I know what she said, and it has nothing to do with faulty memory. As you know, I've shown this book to many people. I keep my brains in my pocket, and for years I write down the important things that happened during the day. And this was written down right after we met with Hillary, and so it has nothing to do with a faulty memory. And I'll read to you exactly what the conversation was that I had with Hillary. This is just a couple days after what happened in Benghazi when the bodies came out. I gave Hillary a hug and shook her hand, and she said that we are going to have the filmmaker arrested who was responsible for the death of your son. Now, not only did I write that down, she also told that to other family members, and then about a half hour or 45 minutes later, she went on national TV at the casket ceremony, and she repeated the same untruth. She said, as I recall, rage was directed towards the American embassy as a result of the awful film that we had no part in. Mm-hmm. So she not only lied to the American people, she also lied to myself and to other family members.
What, sir, would you like Hillary Clinton to say?
What would cause that?
I'm asking you, sir, would you like Hillary Clinton to say?
Well, I would like really for her to come clean and to tell the truth. I would like to know personally why there was no rescue attempt made. If there had been a rescue attempt, my son would still be alive.
As you step by and you look at all that is transpiring now in the political arena, especially surrounding Gold Star families, and, you know, families like you who've made the ultimate sacrifice for our country, what goes through your mind?
Well, I have a lot of empathy for all Gold Star families. I know one family in particular has been in this spotlight recently, and that was Khan. And he was definitely a patriotic American citizen who was also a moderate Muslim. And we need to think about these moderate Muslims who are American citizens. They have the same national security concerns that all of us do. And what we have to realize is that ISIS, another radical terrorist group, they not only kill Jews, Christians, gays, they also kill moderate Muslims who do not agree with their radical jihad and their interpretation of Shiite law. And I'm sure when the election comes out next year, they're going to have to make the decision who should they vote for based upon who will do the best job of defending this country.
Right.
And I think Hillary Clinton proved at Benghazi that she was incapable of protecting 35 of her own employees. So how could she possibly protect 330 million Americans at home?
Do you think that Mr. Trump should apologize to Mr. Khan?
You know, I really don't know what's been said. I haven't seen a TV set since last Monday
or
Tuesday.
Well, he has not apologized.
Camping with my daughter and taking her to a rodeo, so I'm not really sure what he said.
Well, he has not apologized. He actually said that he has sacrificed because he has built buildings and created jobs. And I can actually play a bit of what his son, Eric Trump, said on CBS this morning about how exactly his father has reacted to the cons. Let's listen.
They want an apology. Would your father be willing to apologize and move on?
Well, I think that's a great question for him, and I think he has by calling them a hero. You know, and in terms of the one question, whether you've made a sacrifice, I think my father has. Now, that's certainly not the ultimate sacrifice. The ultimate sacrifice is a soldier dying for this nation and dying to protect the three of us. There's no question about it.
Difficult for him to apologize, Eric, on anything. You know him probably better than anybody.
My father's a fighter. You know, my father's a fighter, and I think this country needs a fighter. And I think he was attacked the other day, and he was attacked viciously. And by the way, that's politics. You're going to get attacked.
So Eric Trump is saying that his father sort of apologized by calling, you know, Khan's son a hero, and that Donald Trump has also sacrificed for this country.
Well, I would agree with what Mr. Trump said. Definitely, Khan was an American hero. He was a patriotic American, and he was also a moderate Muslim.
But should Mr. Trump apologize?
You know, I don't know what he originally said, and I don't know what he said since then. I know who should apologize, and that would be Hillary Clinton for lying to the American families who lost their loved ones, as well as to the American public. You know, she hasn't apologized for that yet. In fact, she's even doubled down and called us liars, which is not appropriate at all. Because, like I say, either she's lying or she has a bad memory.
Who are you endorsing this election?
Well, my son would still be alive if Mrs. Clinton was performing her job properly as Secretary of State. So in good conscience, I cannot vote for the person who was directly responsible for the death of my son. There's only two choices, and obviously I support Donald Trump. And the main reason is because national security, as well as the economy, are the two most important issues that voters are going to have to decide upon next November.
And just the last question I'll ask you. Do you wish that Mr. Trump would stop talking about the cons now?
I haven't watched a TV set since either last Monday or Tuesday, so I'm not really sure.
He's continued to double down on Mr. Khan.
You know, when Hillary Clinton on several occasions has called the Benghazi victims' families liars, would that be should she apologize for that?
Thank you, sir, for your time this morning. I do appreciate you stopping
by. Thank you.
Charles Woods.
Thank you very much.